hello everyone, welcome and thank you for joining today's webinar. My name is Laurent Delegue. I work for Obeo and I will be your moderator today. So before we start, I just want to inform everybody that your microphone is muted to avoid background noise. After today's talk, we will have a question and answer session. So there is a Q&A button that you can use to ask your questions during or after the talk. Questions will be answered during the Q&A session. And finally, this webinar is being recorded and will be made available on the Capella YouTube channel. So it is my pleasure to welcome and introduce today's speaker, Stéphane Lacran. Stéphane is one of the founders of Obeo and he has run the company for 12 years. He is now the director of Obeo Canada and oversees the business development in North and South America for the company. Stéphane Lacran is passionate about MBSE and very much involved in the development of the Capella community. And he is the INCOSI co-chair for the Systems Engineering Tools Database Working Group. And without further ado, I'm going to hand over to Stéphane.
Thank you, Laurent. Making me presenter.
Stéphane, you are now presenter. The virtual floor is yours.
Right. Thank you, Laurent, for this introduction. And good morning, good afternoon, good evening to all the attendees who joined us today. On the agenda today, I will start with a brief introduction to Obeo and also to Capella for those who may not be familiar with the tool. Then I will talk about the challenge around achieving the single source of truth with MBSE and how publication for Capella and cloud for Capella are contributing to achieving this goal. As a side note, you may see in some of the slides the three letters abbreviation we use to name these products, P4C for publication for Capella and C4C for cloud for Capella. It is pretty consistent with the third main add-on Obeo is commercializing, Team for Capella, that we also called T4C. So hopefully we will have some time for a nice Q&A session at the end, as Laurent just mentioned. So let's start with a brief overview of Obeo, which is the company I work for. So Obeo was established in 2005. We are an independent company with a global reach. Our headquarters are based in France. We have an office in North America, also managing South America operations, and we have distributors in Asia as well. We are about 50 very talented people in the company, and a lot of them are software engineers. So we are a software company specialized in creating innovative modeling technologies, mainly as open source. And we help our customers to build the right modeling tool for designing or operating their complex systems, thanks to the products and services we provide. We operate in many sectors such as aerospace and defense, transportation, energy, healthcare, and services. We have three main offers. The first one is for system engineers and leverage on Capella, as you'll learn more about today. Our second offer is for enterprise architects with Obeo Smart EA, a software implementing the TOGAF and Archimate standards. And finally, our third offer is Obeo Designer, a modeling solution for building your own graphical modeling environment. Obeo Designer is leveraging the Sirius open source framework. And if you want to learn more about Sirius, join us for the 2021 SiriusCon annual online conference from the 15th to the 17th of June. You'll find more information on this event on the SiriusCon.org website. So the next topic is a brief introduction to Capella. Not going to spend a lot of time on this, as I'm pretty sure a lot of you know already Capella very well. But for those who do not know Capella, the basics are Capella is a model-based system engineering tool So in short, it's a modeling tool for system engineers. Capella is used for formalizing the customer need and for designing the architecture of the solution. And the main benefit when using Capella is better management of engineering concerns, such as management of multi-level of engineering, of IVV activities, of interfaces, of operational and need analysis, and of product line engineering as well. So Capella is awesome at providing an easy to learn modeling environment while scaling to manage the most complex systems. It is easy to learn because Capella has been designed by system engineers for system engineers. It comes with an MBSE method called Arcadia. This method is directly implemented in Capella, enabling rich tooling for an efficient support of systems engineering activities. And the icing on the cake, it all comes for free as Capella is open source. So if you're new to Capella, I recommend starting with this short video, The Spirit of Arcadia and Capella in 7 minutes. And then this tutorial made by Peter Jackson from the Singapore University of Technology and Design. It is quite comprehensive and well done. I can say that Capella is an amazing community, so welcome if you're new to us. We are so happy and grateful to witness that for the last 2 years, around 15 organizations every month are starting to use Capella. Now, let's move to the main topic of today's webinar, the single source of truth. So when reading or listening about MBSE, the term single source of truth appears to be one of the holy grail of MBSE. But this image is more what I'm talking about. MBSE aims at transforming engineering practices from mainly document-centric engineering to model-centric engineering. And what is driving this transformation? Well, to make it simple, we all know that systems are becoming more and more complex, and managing complexity has become a major challenge as defects are growing exponentially with complexity. And these systems and projects complexity translate into more information involved in the system's description and more engineers involved in working on the system as well. So tackling this complexity challenge means two things. First one, better ways to structure and manage the information, which is growing. And two, having a better way for people to communicate and exchange this information. Well, this schema represents these two things. First, the information that was scattered across different documents and often outdated is now centralized and structured in a formalized model. The outcome of this, of course, is that information stays up to date, but also that you can now process this information automatically for verification, simulation, or let's say ICD generation, for instance. The second point is that this information can be shared among stakeholders. And here we are not talking only about system engineers, but all the project and system stakeholders. It means that MBSE is also aiming at breaking the silos that we have created in our engineering organizations. So this is a great schema, great goals from MBSE, but how is Capella helping on this? Well, let's zoom first on the core of the single source of truth, which is the data itself, captured in a need and solution system models. My belief is that organizations and projects will not achieve the single source of truth if system engineers themselves are not the first class citizens contributing and using the actual model. I still see in many occasions when deploying MBSE, modeling activities are organized in a way that only modeling experts or tool experts are the actual ones authoring the models. We usually experience three consequences, making it very difficult to reach the single source of truth. The first consequence is that the actual source of truth is still the document. The reason why is because the modeling experts are constantly catching up with the last modifications made by system engineers. And when the project deadlines approaches, system engineers have no time to lose anymore with models, and you basically end up having a model which is not the truth at all, as it does not match what system engineers have delivered in their documents. So to me, this first consequence comes down to how can everyone consider the model as a single source of truth if even the system engineers don't? Second consequence of this configuration, system engineers did not learn a lot about MBSE because they did not really practice it. It is still obscure to them and they don't really see the value in it. So meanwhile, the modeling experts did learn a lot from the system engineers and the domain of the system they had to put in the model. So that's good for them. And the third consequence I wanted to add is how are we supposed to scale with MBSE in our organizations and transform the systems engineering discipline if it is requiring expertise level from everyone in using a modeling tool? So when it comes down to applying MBSE on a project and you realize that only modeling experts are actually authoring the model, I think you may want to have a closer look at why this is happening. Why can't system engineers author the models themselves? And from what we see and hear from the Capella community, most of the time system engineers and are actually the one using the tool. And this is great feedback, as Arcadia and Capella have been designed with this objective in mind. Having said that, you may have one of the system engineers in a given project who is more experienced with the method and the tool, and that may help or coach the others for onboarding. And this is a very good practice, but everyone should participate and eventually own the model. So still you need to make sure that everyone can actually participate in an efficient manner in authoring the model. So for this, at Obeo, we provide two things. The first one is Team for Capella. You probably know already about this one. Team for Capella enables team members to simultaneously edit their Capella models. This is a great asset when deploying Capella on large team of system engineers. If you want to learn more about Team for Capella, I did a webinar last year on this topic, and the link to the recording is at the bottom right of this slide. The second thing we provide for aiding the collaboration of system engineers is Cloud for Capella. So I will present Cloud for Capella more in detail later in this presentation, but basically with Cloud for Capella, you can access and use Capella from anywhere on the planet. This enables organizations to have their large number of users distributed globally to collaborate on Capella projects. And it's also useful to ease the spread of Capella in an organization, as new users can try and use Capella without requiring any installation. So once again, the idea here is that every system engineers can easily contribute to the system model so that there really is a single source of truth. So now, Capella provides an efficient way for system engineers to create system models that can become the single source of truth for them. But now, we need to communicate this information and to be efficient in the way we communicate this information with others, including customers, requirements engineers, IVQ teams, and so on. So it really becomes, the goal is that it really becomes the single source of truth for all the project stakeholders. So the first thing I can say on this topic of communicating to a larger community than the system engineers is that The semantics that Capella uses coming from the Arcadia method are simple enough so that they can be understood by most of the stakeholders. Again, we see and hear many examples from the Capella community where system engineers use directly the models to discuss the need with the customers or with requirement engineers or with other disciplines like safety or performance engineers. I mean, this is essential that you can use a common language to communicate. Imagine if the plans produced by an architect for building a house could not be understood by all the builders that are going to do the work on the house, or if the architect can't discuss with the future owner of the house using its plan. My second point here is about how we share this information from a tooling perspective, and there are different options. In some cases, you may require that the stakeholders actually install and use Capella to browse this information and maybe to modify it. That can make sense, for instance, if you're sharing models with your suppliers or downstream engineering teams, and you expect them to enter information in the model. But installing Capella is not always the easiest way to do things and to communicate. There are other ways you can share information from Capella models. You may generate documents from them. You may also use the HTML generation add-on. You may export CSV data out of Capella. Generally speaking, Capella is a very open platform and environment, and it is built on open source components like EMF. So there are quite a few technical options when it comes to accessing and sharing data generated by Capella. But now, when we are talking about the single source of truth, we are also talking about digital continuity and digital thread. So we want all the stakeholders to experience improved communication, but also that the data itself flows better between our current silos. And we have now some great insights and return on experience on how we can link and flow the data between those different silos. And Thales did a lot of work for advancing the MBSC practice, especially on topics related to digital continuity. So for instance, I can cite this paper that won the best paper, best MBSC paper award at the 2019 INCOSI International Symposium, and that relates how textual requirements can be linked with Capella models and how it drives VNV activities and test case management. I can also relate this paper published in the 2020 INCOSI International Symposium by Thales again, explaining how MBSC can be used with a project organization using agility, and it helps to understand why and how it makes sense to connect tasks-related artifacts with some of the Capella model elements. There is another major topic where digital continuity definitely makes sense, which is bridging Capella with simulation. And I'm not going to cover this topic today, but we expect to have a webinar on this topic in July, more specifically presenting how to link Capella with MATLAB Simulink. This work was introduced in the Capella annual meeting webinar in February by Oran Navas from Thales. And I know there are many other initiatives around this topic of connecting Capella with simulation tools. We really see here why digital continuity makes sense, and this is where publication for Capella can help. I will talk more about it in the next part of this presentation, but really what publication for Capella is about is enabling other stakeholders using application lifecycle management tools to access and link data created and provided by Capella. So you can actually link and create traceability between a large variety of ALM artifacts, enabling digital continuity and making the most of your single source of truth. So now, having introduced all that, let's have a closer look at publication for Capella. So basically, publication for Capella is a commercial add-on to Capella, enabling fine-grained integration between application lifecycle management tools and Capella. Application lifecycle management tools, so ALM, includes requirements management tools and allow you to efficiently capture, organize, and link work items like requirements, tasks, issues, change requests, test cases, releases, etc. And the goal of publication for Capella is to enable better digital continuity between the different engineering teams, better communication, better collaboration, so that models are used as a single source of truth. And the expected benefit is obviously better efficiency in product development phases, so in the end, faster time to market by breaking the silos and detecting problems earlier in the process. So what are the main functions of publication for Capella? Well, this may not come as a surprise to you that publication for Capella enables you to publish Capella models into a server. This is a very important element of the architecture of the tool, as this is how we make the Capella model information available to others and to other tools and stakeholders, as they can view the model data and diagrams using their web browser without any Capella installation required. So let's demo this. Doesn't want to quit the presentation, right? So publishing a Capella model is simple. From a Capella model, you right-click and select Publish to Server, and then select which model you want to publish and click Finish. The tool will compute and send the information to the publication for Capella server. And once it's published, you can access and navigate this model with a web browser. You can browse the embedded documentation that you may have added on your Capella models, which is quite practical. You may visualize some diagrams and we have added information about elements linked to a given graphical object to ease the navigation. We will add in future publication for Capella release a model tree view on the left of the screen. And one thing we have added as well is the information coming from the semantic browser, which is pretty handy. And also the whole website is using a responsive design, which means that you may use it on smaller screens like tablets or phones. Right, so that was it for this first demo. The second set of publication for Capella functions are related to linking and establishing traceability from an ALM to Capella model elements that have been published. This is a central set of features and a major use case for using publication for Capella. I'm going to demo this in the next slide, but basically, the idea is that any user using an ALM is able to simply establish links directly from the tool he's using for doing his everyday work. No need to install or to learn how to use Capella for that. We support a variety of artifact types to link from, like test cases or issues that you may link with your functional chains or functional exchange scenarios, for example. We also support tasks and releases work items that could be linked with components that needs to be designed or developed for a specific release. And of course, you can find quite a lot of examples for linking with artifacts like a change request or more generally simply requirements, textual requirements. So let's demo this part. So starting with an example with Doors Next. So in this demo, we will see a list of requirements in Doors Next, and we can add new columns to this table. We do so because we want to display different types of trace links that we have created between Capella models and requirements in Doors. Then the tool loads dynamically these links from publication for Capella. First, it gets the links and then more information like names and icons that finally gets displayed. And from there, by hovering with the mouse on any of these links, I can directly obtain information about the Capella element it links to and all the related information on this element. And same thing if you link the requirements with the diagram, you can directly access the corresponding diagrams from Doors Next. These web pages are coming directly from the publication for Capella server, as you may have guessed. Another thing that is quite interesting in Doors, we can see links from requirements to Capella model elements. And on the publication for Capella web pages, we can see what we call backlinks in the external links section. This means that when browsing a Capella model with publication for Capella, you can actually see and navigate links from this Capella model to the requirements in Doors Next, like I'm going to illustrate now. And I'm on this trigger alarm page. And when I click on the link, it brings me back to the page displaying detailed information about this requirement. So in the end, we can navigate both ways. Now, let's see how we create a link. You start by selecting Add Link, and then a creation window is displayed where you can select the link type, the Capella model you want to link your requirement with, and then you can select which type of object you're looking for, so let's say a diagram, and hitting the search button will give you all the possibilities, and finally, you select which diagram, and it's done, the new link is created, then the page reloads, it's taking a couple of seconds in this demo, and the thing I want to illustrate now to finish this demo is that at the same time you created the link from a requirement to a Capella diagram, the backlink was also created in the publication for Capella server, so we can now see that this diagram is linked with requirements 337. Okay, let's switch to another demo with Polarion this time. And in this one, I would like to start by showing you how to configure the connection between Polarion and the publication for Capella server. My point being that this connection is pretty simple to make as we are relying on the OSLC standard. I will tell you more about OSLC later in this presentation. So there are two levels of configuration, and the first one we are seeing right now is made at the Polarion server level, meaning for all Polarion projects. So we are adding the publication for Capella as a friend server, and while doing this, you will have to authenticate yourself in the publication for Capella server to confirm that Polarion can access this information and author it. So once this is done, there is a second level of configuration done at each project level. Indeed, you can specify for each Polarion project which publication for Capella model is accessible. You need to be an administrator of the project to do so. And again, the steps for achieving this are pretty similar to the previous ones. But all in all, this configuration steps are pretty simple and straightforward. So here we are confirming that publication for Capella is going to be a service provider for the Polarion project. And now that this is done, we can continue and access some requirements in Polarion and see how it integrates with publication for Capella. So let's browse the requirements and have a closer look at one of them. So we're going to look at requirements DP315 by opening this item. And now that the detail page is loading and links to Capella model elements are found in the linked work item section of this page, The way you create such a link is pretty similar to what we just saw with Dorn Next. So you can choose first which type of trace link and then select which publication for Capella project to link to. And we have the same kind of window which is being displayed. And we're going to select another type of object, which is a logical function. We can filter by names containing alarm, and we select the trigger alarm function. And that's it. The trace link is created. Right. Let's go back to the presentation. The third set of publications for Capella functions that I wanted to introduce today is enabling a different use case, which is linking requirements directly from Capella by drag and dropping. The idea behind this is similar to what we've discussed, in the sense that we are trying to provide a seamless user experience by having extended integration or tight integration of tools. This means that you can authenticate yourself in the requirements tool directly from Capella, drag and drop requirements into diagrams elements, and by doing so, the requirements are automatically displayed in the Capella diagram with the links. We also provide features that ease the navigation and the synchronization between the two tools. This feature is currently limited to tools managing requirements work item like Polarion, because we are relying on the open source requirements viewpoint add-on to create objects in the Capella model. So let's have a demo of this as well. This is a pretty short demo. The idea here is that you have Capella on the left with your Capella project opened and Polarion on the right of your screen. We are basically going to drag and drop a Polarion requirement onto an element in this model, in this Capella diagram, sorry. And by doing so, a requirement object is created in the Capella model along with its link to the Capella model element. And finally, the result is displayed in the Capella diagram, and we can add or link more requirements from Polarion to Capella as well. And one thing we are not seeing here is that the user will have to authenticate itself on Polarion the first time it tries to drag and drop a requirement. Okay, so this was a very short demo for this function. So let's summarize this high level view of publication for Capella features. In the first workflow, you publish Capella models into a server, and then you link these published models with work items directly from the ILM tool, as well as enabling any stakeholders to visualize Capella models with a browser. The second workflow is a different one. It provides direct integration within Capella with a requirement tool only. You may also publish these models in the publication for Capella server. Sorry, and also still link your published model with your ILM work items. Except for requirement work items this time, for which the ILM will not see links that were created within Capella, neither Capella would see requirements link that would be created from the ILM. So in the end, these two different workflows do not target the same users. So the first one targets mainly the ILM users, the second one, the Capella users. And publication for Capella supports both workflows, but does not reconcile requirements links that you may have created within Capella with the one you have created from the requirement management tool. For the moment, it is not an issue for our customers, as they are interested in using either one workflow or the other. But we do see some value in this, as it will enable an even more seamless integration. So stay tuned, as this may come up as one of the next publication for Capella versions. Now, a focus on the ALM tools we support. In publication for Capella version 1.1, we support interoperability with both Polarion and the IBM JAS platform, including Doors Next, workflow management, and test management. Nevertheless, the drag and drop function is not supported yet on the JAS platform. If you are using Teamcenter requirements, you should look into System Modeling Workbench, which is a product commercialized by Siemens. And we are also planning on supporting integration with other tools. So publications for Capella mainly relies on the OSLC interoperability mechanism. And OSLC stands for Open Service for Lifecycle Collaboration. It is a standard defining a set of APIs to interact with data via the web, so like searching, visualizing, analyzing. And the bottom line is that for ALM tools implementing OSLC, the integration with publication for Capella comes at almost no cost. So expect to see this list of supported tools growing soon. And last slide on publication for Capella, a few words on what's coming next. Publication for Capella is a new product at Obeo. We released version 1 at the end of last year. We just released version 1.1 with JAS and Doors Next support. And we are making it evolve as fast as we can based on our customers' requests. So please do not hesitate to contact us if you want to interact with us and have your most important needs taken into account. We have a few things we consider important in our list of things to add to publication for Capella. The first one is, I already mentioned it, we are thinking about the best way to reconcile both workflow, creating traceability links from both the ALM and from Capella. The second important topic we are going to add more ALM tools support. We have in mind tools like Jira, for instance, and we are also currently working on adding the drag and drop support from Doors Next, which is missing. We're going to improve the web browsing part as well, adding a tree view on the left, as I mentioned, but also a search capability among other things. And another important topic we are looking at the moment is adding some model review capability to publication for Capella. Now, let's switch to the last part of this presentation, Cloud for Capella. So Cloud for Capella is also a new product we recently released. And what is it? Well, with Cloud for Capella, you can benefit from a ready-to-use, pre-installed Capella environment without any local installation. Obeo deploys this environment for you on a secured cloud infrastructure accessible remotely via RDP over HTTPS. And RDP stands for Remote Desktop Protocol. It provides a graphical user interface to connect and use a remote computer. So for Capella, it means that you get the same Capella tool. The only difference is that it's not running on your local machine, but on a remote desktop by accessing the desktop of the distant machine. And anyone with the right credentials can access a remote Capella workbench and collaborate with other team members on modeling activities. So using Cloud for Capella brings a few benefits. It is streamlining your MBSC deployment at different levels. First, it eases the onboarding of new MBSC users, as it does not require any installation on the user's machine. Some customers see it as a game changer, as it accelerates the MBSC adoption within the organization. Anyone who wants to try it and join others already using Capella on the project, it's just a matter of a minute to access it. Besides, some of our customers have different operating systems on their machines. They have Windows, Linux, Mac, but Capella is mainly tested and used with Windows. Well, it doesn't matter anymore with Cloud for Capella. Everyone can connect remotely from their machine to the remote environment. And moreover, you are sure that everyone runs on the same Capella version with the same version of add-ons. We are also assisting you with upgrading your environment to the new Capella versions on an on-demand basis. And another important benefit is that it eases collaboration in organizations and teams that are widespread geographically, especially when working with Team for Capella, where network latency matters. And finally, you also benefit from OBO administrating these machines for you, including user account creation as well as constant and automatic backup of your Capella environment. So, in case of any problem, you can always restore a previous version of your model. We have a few different options with Cloud for Capella that you can combine depending on which environment you need. The first one is Classic Capella, as downloaded from the Capella download page. The second one is the extended package, which comprises Capella plus a selected set of open source add-ons that we tested to make sure that they work well together. The third option is including Team for Capella for real-time and concurrent model authoring. And the first option is including publication for Capella. Also, a few words on licensing options. We offer monthly subscriptions with Cloud for Capella, and we support per user named license as well as floating licenses. And in terms of deployment, each AWS machine used to deploy Capella is dedicated to a single customer, and we can also adapt the machine location depending on your team location, basically. So this is not easy to demo Cloud for Capella, especially in the context of a webinar with WebEx and all that. But I'm going to share with you something we are working on in the roadmap of Cloud for Capella. So this is just a prototype, but in this demo, we are in a Mac environment, and as we have configured this remote desktop connection so that you do not access the entire desktop on the remote computer, but you just get the UI from Capella, and the result is quite interesting as the user experience just feels like you're running Capella on your local machine. And this is probably not exactly what we will offer in the product in the future, but definitely something close where you get the same feeling as you're using Capella directly on your local computer, but it will probably be embedded within a web browser. So stay tuned for more information on this. Okay, with that, I hope you enjoyed this presentation, and I would like to thank you all for your attention. It's now time to move to the Q&A session. So feel free to ask your question in the Q&A window. Laurent, do we have any question already?
Yes, Stéphane, we have a few questions already. Some of them are really about the features you demonstrated today, whereas others are more general questions about Capella and Arcadia. So I suggest we should start first with the questions that are relevant to today's presentation, really, and then we move to the Arcadia Capella questions, if that's okay for you.
Yeah, that's okay, Laurent. And sorry for the way your name is displayed here. I don't know what OpenOffice did, but it basically messed up
Yes,
the
it
size.
doesn't matter. No problem at all. So I guess the first question regarding publication for Capella is, what is the lowest level model element that you can link a requirement with?
Well, I'm going to start by saying that Laurent Delegue, who is moderating this webinar today, is the product manager for publication for Capella. So you may be at some point in a better position than me for answering some of this question, but I guess it's when I can answer it. So when you are linking requirements or other elements to a Capella model element, you can select any model element from a Capella model. When we are publishing the Capella models to the publication for Capella servers, we are publishing all the Capella model elements. We are also publishing the diagrams. So yeah, the answer is any element from a Capella model.
Absolutely. This includes, for example, messages in a sequence diagram or a state transition in a state diagram or these kind of things. Really, any element in the model can be linked to. The second question we have regarding publication for Capella is it compatible with Team for Capella? And do we propose a specific workflow in this case?
To my knowledge, we do not propose a specific workflow. You can work with Team for Capella, with your team, and somebody in your team will manually publish the model that is in Team for Capella into publication for Capella. I think we are thinking about better integration at some points, like we could have models published directly from the Team for Capella server into publication for Capella, but that's not something we have at the moment.
No, that is correct. In the roadmap, this is a low priority item because actually it is so simple to just publish the model with the standard publication from Capella. When you're working with Team for Capella, you just have to export your project locally and then publish it to the publication for Capella server. So it's really quite straightforward. So working on a better integration with Team for Capella would maybe not be so valuable as improving other aspects of the tool for the time being. Okay, that's all for the questions regarding publication for Capella in the chat. So unless there are any questions, we will move to the more general Capella and Arcadia questions. So first, well, Stefan, I will list the four questions and you will answer them in the order you prefer, I guess, because there are quite a lot. So first is, what is the suite of tools that comes with Capella, especially regarding simulation, interfaces to requirements tools, configuration management tools? Second is, how close to the SysML language standard does Capella conform? And three, in addition to the standard diagrams, does Capella allow additional diagrams such as data flow diagrams, N2 matrices, and FFBD functional flow block diagrams? And four is, can you describe the Arcadia methodology?
Right. Thank you, Laurent. So for the last one, describing the Arcadia methodology, we have a website first where the Arcadia methodology is described. We have a Capella YouTube channel, and we did quite a lot of webinars, and some of them are more focused on describing the Arcadia method. There is a book as well from Jean-Luc Varin, who created the method, that is that you can purchase, and that has quite an extensive description of the method. But I mean, to make it simple, the Arcadia method comes with five engineering perspectives, and The two first one engineering perspectives are about describing the need. The first engineering perspective is the operational analysis, where you're going to describe the context in which the system will be developed. So you are not modeling the system and the system need at this stage, but really the whole context. So it's really starting with why. And the second engineering perspective, still describing the need, is a system need analysis, where you're going to describe the system, but as a black box. So you are really defining the external interfaces of your system and the boundaries of your system at this stage. The next three engineering perspectives are about designing the solution. The first one is the logical architecture, which is about making the main architectural decisions that are not going to be challenged later down into the process when you make more physical choices. So the next engineering level is the physical architecture, when you're going to describe the architecture with technical solutions, I would say, technical choices. And the last stage is the end product breakdown. So the point with those engineering perspectives and the need model and the solution model is that Arcadia is driving the way you're going to do your modeling. And I have described it in a pretty much top-down approach, but actually Arcadia is used in a lot of different contexts, and it can be used very well in bottom-up approaches as well, where you've got an existing system, or mixed approaches. It can be used in more system engineering agile approaches and these kind of things. Right, so that's very a very short description of Arcadia. Yeah. It's quite a comprehensive method.
I'm sorry to interrupt, Stefan. We have a number of other questions suddenly that are regarding P4C and today's presentation more. So I suggest we move to them, and we will go back to Capella Arcadia if we have time at the end.
Yeah.
First. One question is, what if the model has been extended with a specific viewpoint? Will it work with publication for Capella?
So I guess the answer is, and you will correct me, Laurent, the answer is yes, if you extended Capella with a standard way of extending Capella, so I mean using Capella Studio and this kind of tooling.
Yeah, absolutely. That's correct. Unless you do very fancy things in your viewpoint, it will get exported to publication for Capella as along with the rest of the model automatically. Okay. When you publish to publication for Capella, does it include the elements from plugins? For example, does it include the requirements from the requirements plugins? The answer to that is yes. Basically, it's more or less the same question as before. We have a question regarding the drag and drop. So after dragging and dropping requirements from Polarion to Capella, if the requirement is updated in Polarion, does it get updated in Capella automatically? Or can you update the requirement in Capella and publish the change in Capella to Polarion?
Yes, and this is a very good question. I know the high level answer is yes, we have features that help you to manage the fact that requirements may change. And you may have to use different baseline of requirements. Now, I'm not exactly up to speed on how this is done, Laurent, so maybe you can complete my answer.
Yeah, so what is doable is you can receive the changes performed in Polarion within Capella, but you are not supposed to edit the requirements within Capella. Polarion is the repository that owns the that is the single source of truth for these requirements. So it's the only place where you are supposed to edit the requirements and update them. You can just get them into Capella for the sake of supporting traceability with your Capella elements, but you're not supposed to edit them. And if you modify them in Capella, your changes will not get back to Polarion. It's a one-way integration. You can update your requirements to get the latest state of these requirements from Polarion, but you cannot modify them locally. I hope that was clear. So now we have a question. So apparently, somebody needs to be re-explained the part related to the link between requirements and Capella model. I guess it's the drag and drop. Is that correct? Who asked this question? Just let me check. Yes, I believe that's it. So, Stefan, if you can re-explain quickly the drag and drop user story.
Yes. So the idea is that you're a Capella user. You are using Capella to do your system models, and while you are doing so, you can have Polarion the site, and you can decide to link requirements to a Capella model element by drag and dropping these textual requirements onto the Capella diagram, for example. So when you are doing this, what's happening is that it's going to create the requirement in the Capella model. It's going to create also a link from this new requirement in the Capella model to the model element you are linking this requirement to. And finally, it's going to display this requirement and the link in the diagram where you drag and dropped the requirement in the first place. So I hope it makes it clear.
Sarah, I hope that's clearer now. Otherwise, please write another question in the Q&A box. In the meantime, we will move to the next question. So you said, Stefan, that you can associate other work items than just requirements, for example, test cases, tasks, releases to model elements. Can you explain how it would impact the project management across engineering teams? For example, electrical, hardware, software, simulation, and so on. Or do you want me to try and answer?
No, I'm trying to think of an example. Yeah, so I can talk about a test case, for example. So you may be managing your test cases within your ALM tool, and by linking a test case to an external scenario, for example, well, first of all, you can have a precise understanding of what the test case will be. So it can be of help for the person who is going to have to write the test case procedure. And from there, I mean, you could even imagine to automate some of this procedure from the information that comes from the model. And from there as well, you can do requests in the Capella model and find out what I would say components need to be available or delivered in the system so that you you can actually run the test case. So I mean, Thales did demonstrate some of these features in a webinar. I think it was probably last year or the year before, but the idea with that is that you can organize your test campaigns based on the information that is in the model and when components of the system will be made available. So let's say you have a first delivery of your system and you know which components are going to be delivered. By doing a query, you can then calculate which test case you can do at this date and then organize your test campaign. That's an example of how the system model can help you to manage things which are outside of just designing the architecture of the system.
Okay.
And just sorry. And by the way, having traceability between a test case and also having traceability from the model to the requirements helps you to, you know, find information about what requirements am I validating when I'm running this test case. So I mean, pretty straightforward example, but yeah.
Absolutely. Okay, so we have more questions. Is there any online synchronization between Capella and ALM tools if the linked artifact is updated in one of the two tools? So, Stefan, do you want to answer this one?
No, I will let you answer this one, Laurent, maybe.
Okay, so that's actually a very good question. That's been pointing an identified limitation on our side and on everybody's side, actually, when it comes to OSLC. The OSLC mechanism and standard does not define any way to synchronize repositories when the linked artifacts evolve. So we suffer from this shortcoming as well as any OSLC repository. We are considering and thinking about ways to support notifying remote repositories or at least defining user interfaces to help users identify what has changed since a given link was created to be able to verify the validity of old links. But for the moment, this is a work in progress and preliminary thoughts, but there is no actual support in the tool. So that's it for this question. You're welcome. Is there any relation between Cloud for Capella and Sirius Web OBO Cloud Modeler? Are the two envisaged to converge in the future to a web-based modeling capability?
Yes, so there is no relation between the two. Cloud for Capella is not Capella working with web technologies. Cloud for Capella is simply deploying the Capella desktop application on machines which are in the cloud and then accessing this machine remotely. So basically displaying the window, the display of this remote machine on your local machine. I mean, at some point in the future, we may do things with the OBO Cloud platform to help. I mean, we may do things, other may do things, Thales may do things with the OBO Cloud platform to propose some web interfaces for authoring Capella models, but that's certainly not something that we have in the roadmap for the moment. I would just add that publication for Capella is about publishing Capella models in the server and then being able to browse these models into a web browser. And for publication for Capella, we are reusing some of the components of Sirius Web and the OBO Cloud platform. So yeah, that there are some reuse here, much more than what's coming with Cloud for Capella.
Absolutely. Okay, thank you, Stefan. And we are already a bit late, but I think we have time for one last question, which is, are the links made with publication for Capella associated to baselines? So I'm assuming it's about Polarian baselines. And the answer for that is that currently Polarian baselines are not really taken into account by publication for Capella. So I would say that the behavior is not defined and we need to work with the Polarian team to clarify exactly what would be expected and what we can do to support Polarian baselines. But for the time being, this is out of the scope of the tool. And I believe we have gone over all the questions.
Yeah, just as a compliment, maybe to your answer, Laurent, on the publication for Capella side, you can publish different version of your Capella models and then decide from Polarion or DORS, for example, to which version you want to create links to.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. So you can have as many versions of the same model as you want in parallel with different links if needed, so that could simulate somehow branches. But you're absolutely correct.
Yeah, that's what we support at the moment, yeah.
Exactly. Unfortunately, I think we are out of time for more questions now. So first, thank you, Stefan, for a great presentation. And thank you, everybody in the audience, for your questions and your time.
Yeah, I will just add that if you have more questions or you have unanswered questions, please do not hesitate to contact me. You've got my email in the slide, which is displayed now.
Yeah, absolutely. Feel free to reach out to Stefan. He'll be glad to answer anything else. So before closing this session, I just want to announce that our next webinar will be on June the 10th, probably around the same time as today. And we will have the pleasure of welcoming Miss Julia Herdies from the Federal University of Santa Maria in Brazil, who will be presenting a nanosat case study with Capella. So more on this topic shortly, very soon, because it's in 2 weeks, actually. Also, do not hesitate to follow the Capella YouTube channel, as you'll get notified when we post the recording of our webinars. I also want to remind everybody that we have a page on the Capella website that is displaying the Capella adopters. If you did not do it already, please go to this page and send us the logo of your organization if you are using Capella. This is really a great and simple way to give back to the community by showing your support. So it would be very much appreciated. And finally, if you have ideas or topics you would like to present in these Capella webinar series, please feel free to contact us. Of course, we'll be very interested. And without further ado, thank you again and goodbye.
Thank you. Goodbye.